Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss an important topic in chemistry, Raoult's law, definition, derivation, uses and limitations. First of all, we are going to see the definition. At constant temperature, the vapor pressure of a solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the solvent. Okay. First of all, the vapor pressure of the solution is equal to P, then the vapor pressure of the solvent is equal to P0, then the mole fraction of solvent is equal to x1, then the mole fraction of solute is equal to x2. Okay, then according to Raoult's law, at constant temperature the vapor pressure of a solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the solvent. Okay, the vapor pressure solution P, then the mole fraction of solvent is equal to x1. So according to Raoult's law, P is directly proportional to the x1. Okay, this is the equation number 1. To eliminate the proportionality, we are going to introduce a constant. P is equal to K into x1. Okay, this is the equation number 2, where K is a constant. Okay, to find out the value of K, we are going to write x1 is equal to 1. Okay, then equation 2 becomes P is equal to K into, where x1 is equal to 1, then P is equal to K. P is equal to K means it also changes, it's equal to K is equal to P0. K is equal to P0, where P0 is a vapor pressure of pure solvent. Okay, substitute the value of K in equation number 2. Okay, P is equal to K P0 into x1. Okay, then P is equal to P0 into x1. This is the mathematical form of the Raoult's law. Then we are going to discuss about how to expand the Raoult's law. Okay, it's well known that after adding solute to the solvent, the vapor pressure of the solution decreases. So, students, note that after adding solute to the solvent, the vapor pressure of the corresponding solution decreases. So, it's well known that it means P0 is greater than P. So, where P0 minus P is called delta P, where delta P is known as lowering of vapor pressure. Lowering of vapor pressure. Lowering of vapor pressure. Okay. Then, now we are going to find out the relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure. So it's a depend as a it is a ratio. Basically it's a ratio. It's a ratio between the lowering of vapor pressure and vapor pressure of the solvent. So according to the above definition, the lowering of vapor pressure is equal to the ratio between lowering of vapor pressure and vapor pressure of the solvent. So it becomes P0 minus P by P0, or it's also equal to delta P divided by P0. Here delta P indicates the lowering of vapor pressure. Okay. I am going to erase this. It's all on that. Now, I am going to take this equation. Okay. This is equation number 3. Then it's equal to delta P by P0 is equal to P0 minus P by P0. Okay. Then in this equation number 3, substitute the value of substitute the value of P. It's well known that P is equal to P0 into x1. So it goes here. Then delta P by P0 is equal to P0 minus P0 into x1 by P0. Now, just take out the P0 from the numerator. Then delta P by P0 is equal to P0 is taken out. Then 1 minus x1 by P0. So P0 cancel each other. Then we are going to get delta P by P0 is equal to 1 minus x1. It's well known that x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. So x2 is equal to 1 minus x1. So, substitute this value in equation number 4 here. So, what should we get? Delta P by P0 is equal to x2. It's well known that then according to this equation number 5, the relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to the mole fraction of the solute. The relative lowering of vapor pressure of the solution is equal to the mole fraction of the solute. So this is the final equations we are going to get in the derivation of Raoult's law. Okay. Next we are going to see the what are the uses of Raoult's law. Uses. It is mainly used to find out the, it is used to find out the molecular mass of solute. Now we are going to see how to find out the molecular mass of solute by using the Raoult's law. Okay. Delta P by P0 equal to X2. This is equation number 5. Then it's well known that X2, it means a mole fraction of the solute is equal to N2 by N1 plus N2, where N1 is a number of moles of solvent and N2 is a number of moles of solute. Substitute this value in equation number 5 here. Then delta P by P0 is equal to N2 divided by N1 plus N2. Okay. This is equation number 6. So it's well known that for dilute solution, the value of N2 is very very low, therefore it can be eliminated from the denominator. So it becomes delta P by P0 is equal to N2 by N1. This is equation number 7. Okay. Equation number 7. Then we are going to get that where N1 is equal to W1 by M1. It's the weight of solvent divided by molecular weight of solvent. Okay. Then N2 is equal to W2 by M2. This is equal to weight of solute divided by molecular weight of solute. So just apply the value of n1 and n2 in the equation number 7, it will becomes delta P by P0 is equal to n2, it means W2 by m2 divided by n1 W1 by m1. Right, okay. Then it becomes delta P by P0 is equal to W2 by m2 into m1 by W1 when it comes to the upper part. So we are going to get delta P by P0 is equal to W2 into M1 divided by M2 into W1. This equation is a very, very important equation. It's mainly used to find out the molecular mass of the solute. It means M2. So this is the equation number 8. Then it can be rearranged. So delta P by P0 is equal to W2 into M1 divided by M2 into W1. Just reverse these two sides. It means LHS and RHS. P0 by delta P is equal to M2 into W1 by W2 into M1. Then we are going to find out the M2. So M2 is equal to M2 is equal to, this is equation number 9. M2 is equal to P0 by delta P into W2 into M1 by W1. Okay, they are going to multiply, it's going to divide. Okay, so this equation is number 10. This is a very, very important equation. It is used to find out the molecular mass of the solute. Okay, then we are going to see the limitations. Limitations. Okay, limitations. We are going to see the limitations of the Raoult's law. Limitations. Limitations. One, it is applicable to only dilute solutions. Then number two, it is applicable to solutions containing non-volatile solute. Then number three, it is applicable to solution containing solute that does not undergo dissociation or association. Association. Okay. These are the limitations of the Raoult's law. Okay, students. Watch it. Use it.